Hi, I'm Beatrice Ghezzi.
And I'm Orly Quick.
And together, we are both dance classes.
Welcome back to our second collection of Both Dance Meets, which is part of our ongoing project for the Teachers Rehab.
In this second edition, we are interviewing five practitioners who have made an important contribution to the dance scene in the UK.
We'll meet Angela Andrews, a Lindy Hop veteran.
We will meet Hannah Sampson and Emmy Butler from Stopgap.
Gabriel Bravo Rivera, aka Happy Feet, a Dominican bachata specialist.
And Donna Schoenher, founder and director of Ballet for Life and Moving to Wellbeing.
We hope you enjoy these new interviews.
And if you miss the first collection, you can catch up and head to our YouTube channel.
Enjoy!
You're
coming from the flight.
Yeah,
no?
Well, I arrived at midnight. Midday. Okay.
How was it?
Yeah, good. Long. I didn't.
Yeah, yeah. No, I know. Those times. I love those times. Was it good? Yeah. Which festival was it?
It was a symposium. Symposium bachata festival.
Where?
Edinburgh.
Edinburgh. Nice. Yeah.
But really good, actually. Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I enjoyed it because I was the only one teaching Dominican. So they love my workshop.
The specialist.
The king.
Yeah. The king.
Exactly. Part of the music is. We are. But now, lately, I created one step that is just like that. So you can learn with me.
Yeah.
So you can do lateral step.
Yeah.
So you can do lateral step. You not remember the maha?
Oh,
the maha,
is it this one?
Yeah. So normally we have this like
da, a bam, bam, bam.
Tap, but you do on the spot. Tap,
oh,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now we do variation, we do tiki kum, kum, ka, a. Yeah. For example, we do this on the spot, tap, 1, 2, 3. Lateral este, we do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and let's go with the slide. We do tiki kum, 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 ah, 1, 2, 3, tiki kum, 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 ah, 1, 2, 3, tiki kum, kum, kum.
Yeah, so my name is Gabriel. I'm from Bolivia originally, but I've been living in Barcelona for 8 years. And then I moved into London in 2012. So it's going to be like, how long? 2004, it's almost 19 years actually out from Bolivia. I went to a wedding with a friend. And then so the wedding was a bit boring. And then they took me, okay, let's go to the Latin place. Do you know to dance salsa? I thought, of course. I know to dance salsa. Let's go there. I will show off my skills. So we went there. It was in Barcelona. It was the really nice club called Mil Pasos. And it was actually that more or less this time when not many people were in yet. And then when I was dancing with my friends and showing off 2-3 steps I had, that's it. And then when the proper dancers started arriving and I saw them to dance, and I just went to sit down because I realized I didn't know to dance at all. And then in the end I saw some advertisement there, salsa classes. So I thought I need to take them. I need to take them because I want to do this. So I started learning salsa once a week. And apparently I was doing well. Even my teacher was telling me off all the time because I had bad habits of vicious movements of my cumbia, the background with what they normally dance in Bolivia, the cumbia. And that's it. So she was telling me off because I was doing something weird that it wasn't as part of salsa. And I was kept doing it because I couldn't help it, you know, just was taking the kick, like moving my head and it's, no, don't kick it like that. So yeah, it's the way I started taking classes once a week. And of course, it's like everyone else realized, you can tell me as well, that it's like a drug addiction. Once you try it, you want it more. So I started one day and then discovered Thursdays. Okay, let's go Thursday. Even I was traveling quite far, it was an hour journey by bus going back home. So I didn't care, I didn't mind because I was finished at 1 a.m. on Thursday, going back for 1 hour, and then going to work at 8 a.m. next day, but I didn't care, I really love it. And then I added Friday. Oh, Friday we used to go for dinner and then dancing. Then Saturday, oh, Saturday as well. And then Sunday again. Sunday, so it started Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And yeah, so almost every day. And then I discovered festivals. Oof. Amazing festival, the whole day dancing, taking classes, workshops, and party at night. Yeah, so it's how it started. But I started with salsa. So I didn't know what bachata was. So when I was waiting for my class at, on Sunday, I heard the music upstairs because there was two floors club. And I thought, what's that? I went upstairs and they were rehearsing. And just standing there, and actually the teacher asked me, could you help us, please? Yes, yes. What should I do? Just stand up here, because we need the person, because was missing one guy. And the partner was trying just, you know, to move around and to just get situated where the choreo or where the movement should be done. And just stand up here, okay. And the following week, why you don't try? You can try if you want. Okay. So apparently I did well because I was, you know, had no pressure, just was trying. And then the following week, come on, just do it. You have been doing now for many, many times. Now do it. And ended up doing the bachata choreo with them. But I didn't expect, I didn't know what even bachata was. Actually, I used to listen to the music and it's exactly this song.
My city, Tarija, in Bolivia. So I think it's influenced from Spain, you know, Sevillanas.
Yeah.
The Sevillanas are moving, so they have the primera, segunda, tercera, cuarta. But the idea normally when dance the Sevillana, you start crossing with your partner. So the cueca is similar, but it's a little bit more active. And okay. We use a handkerchief. Oh. So yeah, they said the cueca was made for, you know, to the guy. Is try to conquistar, not flirt, something nicer.
Conquer. Conquer. That's
yeah,
it.
Conquer, but more than conquer, like okay. You know, like flirt. You flirt the flirt with a lady and to do nice things, more
flirting,
romantic.
Flirting with a lady, but in a try to seduce.
Yeah, that way. I don't know, it's too not sexual. Because basically there's a step when you do the you do handkerchiefs, you both use, so with the cross, you tack, 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 tack. So at some point, you get closer to, and you start playing with the handkerchief, like looking at each other, you dance, you can go together, forward, back, and you have the handkerchief, so I can, like, you know, seduce, it makes the nice movements. And then we separate, and we start again, so we start crossing, like, we move the handkerchief like that. Yeah, that's it, it's easy, yeah. Yeah, that's it, so easy. We start crossing, so we have two parts, and so we start again, so we have the same thing, but you have different crosses. You can pass the handkerchief here, I can pass here, and you can do also to me, that's it, and then we separate, that's it, and then we start crossing.
That time, there wasn't any salsa there. So that's why our salsa used to dance, but it's like a cumbia, normal cumbia Argentinian.
Clubs.
Yeah, we have the clubs, any party, weddings, school parties used to dance just cumbia. But the cumbia is, you can dance on your own, also with a partner, but without holding hands. You can just ask someone to dance, but it's just you do your own moves, and especially with this group, Ráfaga. Even you can hear here in Europe, I know people in Spain, also people are here in Aventura, Ráfaga. And yeah, so that's the cumbia I used to dance. And folklore as well, I used to dance folklore, but nothing to do with the Latin dance.
Yeah. Actually, this is the cumbia, look, this is the cumbia, that's this part, like. Yeah. And it's a dance. Yeah, free. That's it. That's it, the cumbia. And then we can hear on the... Or you can do on your spot. Like I can do on your spot.
And I'm following the two lines.
Yeah, that's it.
And how yeah. do you go through then?
Huh? No, you don't change that one. You're just here. No. Yeah. So then, if you do now on the with your partner, so you get the confidence to go to your partner. You can dance like a. Yeah, exactly. And it's a. Exactly, that's it.
It's like I've got a syncopation.
Yeah. Yeah, so this is, for example, I do the kick, like...
Everyone thinks the same. So as a Latino, I'm supposed to dance salsa bachata, but even now when I'm teaching, I have people coming, because, you know, we have different levels, and they come to me and say, no, but... you know, I'm Mexican, I'm Colombian, I'm Ecuadorian, so I should do intermediate level higher. I thought, no, we have, what happened to me, as I told you, my teacher was telling me off all the time, so I had to relearn. So, because the way we dance is different than the way to dance, I'm not sure if you can say proper one, or it's like a European or more a structural way to dance. So there we dance just as we feel it, and we do the move that we think is okay with the music, that's it. But we don't have any structure, we don't have a technique to apply on the dance floor or match with your partner, but if you don't learn in a school.
The folklore or even the tarantela, you start doing, of course, you hold hands, yes, we stand here, and we start doing here. So the people can pass underneath, exactly, oh. That's it, and then we start going like that, and there's people like that. So that.
Information.
Yeah, but it's like a long queue. That is the good thing when you have in a line. So every time whoever joins the dance floor, in a line.
No, I was explaining to someone here, I used to be a taxi boy. Really? Oh, shit. And then I realized when taxi boy, the proper translation is different. Okay, so a taxi dancer is, there, I used to, I guess because they don't use the English as proper as here, they used to call taxi boy. But here, taxi boy, I think, is different stuff. Yeah. But, that's why we prefer to say taxi dancer. Because a taxi dancer is basically a person who go there and dances non-stop almost. So it used to be like a 4 or 5 guys with a t-shirt or with the logo of the club, or in this case, Mil Pasos. It had Mil Pasos t-shirt, and people know. And also there are many more girls than boys. Or even if you go, you know, the boys, they. If you go to a club, you normally go to chat, you drink, and you stand, and you're talking, you go to the terrace, blah, blah, blah. But the taxi dancers, we are there to dance. Because there are many girls without dancing, or the girls in the mid-age, they are not being asked from the guys to dance. So the taxi dancers were there to dance with them. Teaching or dancing for about 8 years there in Barcelona. So someone asked me to cover a class because they didn't know. I didn't have an idea to teach. But actually started in Bolivia. When I went to Bolivia and I went to find a club, I believe it happens to you as well. Wherever you travel to, you find the first thing you search for is a dance club, right? It's everyone. So exactly. Exactly, the same when you go to buy a shoe, you try if it can be good for dancing or not. So the first thing you do traveling somewhere is to find a club. So I went to dance in Bolivia, it's a small club, and they were just the couple who were running the business, and I took my 3 cousins there. So that's it, we were sitting, drinking, no one was there because it was early. So I had the time changed completely from Barcelona. It used to be at 11, used to already be dancing. But in Bolivia, no, at 11, no one was in the club. So just four of us and the owners of the business. So the owner was a Cuban girl and a local girl from my city. And so I asked my cousin to dance with me. And I was trying to do the steps, but I couldn't because I need to do my stuff as a leader, someone who know as a follower. But in that case, she didn't know. And then that couple, the owner, so they took us. Okay, so let's dance. So the guy asked my cousin to dance, and then she asked me to dance. And we start dancing. Of course, she knew to dance. I could do nice stuff. And then she was saying, wow, 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 where are you from? I'm from here. It's Norway. Why? It's Norway. No one is dancing like that here. Yeah, I'm from here, but I live in Barcelona. Ah, okay, that makes sense. So yeah, so why don't you join us in the class we do this day, blah, blah, blah. So I went there to join the class. And then they apparently had a fight, so they didn't work together anymore. And she asked me to teach. Why don't teach us what you know? I thought, no, to be a teacher, you need to prepare, or to be prepared at least. No, but you teach us. No. I think I need to be prepared to teach. And then she convinced me. She was constantly, every day, teach us. I will get the people, I will get the venue, just teach us. And just she convinced me, ended up teaching, and they liked it. And it's how I started teaching. So then I went to Barcelona, I did a cover for someone, and then I moved here. So I haven't done more than that.
Like that, or I can do like a tan. So it's like a merengue, but I start all the time jumping.
Oh, it's all the time up.
Yeah, so all the time jumping like that. That is the tarantela we dance in Bolivia. So we have that section, cueca, more folklore, more fun way. So cueca, chacarera, tarantela. A tarantela, carnival, uh-huh. All the time, tarantela. So, and then we have, that's the folklore section. Mm. And then we have cumbia.
Yeah.
Yeah, cumbia is the one that we dance from, normally when we go to parties, like school parties. But cumbia, you dance in a partner, but just away from each other.
No touch.
The max touch, you can do like a claps like that together, but we are dancing like that on our own step, so you can do just this, or you can then do like more tiki-tiki,
tin-tin-tiri-tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki.
Exactly so. Exactly. So you see that kick. Is that the kick I was using? So I was using when I was learning.
Which is the kick, sir? A bit like a Cali salsa.
Similar, yeah. But and then you start at some point, if you have more like confidence, you can hold hands with the, but normally it's like that.
Facing.
Exactly, facing each other. And normally the dance floor, it's exactly, so if you start here, the next couple come to join to the dance floor, stands next to you. Next, so it's
like
lines.
Like a line.
Yeah, it's not like, you know, everywhere. If you are everywhere, it's like you feel alone. So I think it's because we are a bit shy. But you try to dance, you know, next to each other, you can feel like I'm more close to someone, you know, you're more in a group. Yeah. But the good thing of it is when you do the other dances, like the folklore or even the tarantela, you start doing, of course, you hold hands. Yes, we start here, and we start doing here. So the people can pass underneath, exactly. Oh, yeah. That's it, and then we start going like that, and there's some people like that. So that.
Formations.
Yeah, but it's like a long queue. That is the good thing when you have in a line. So every time, whoever joins the dance floor, in a line.
Very nice.
And then if you do folklore as well, so we dance between each other, we cross, but each one has a line to follow, to maintain. Chacarera, we have the cumbia as well. So everything is, that can be, if it's full, the dance floor is full, line here, line there. So lines. That's a, it's a party there.
Yeah, so that is my teacher asked me, I want to talk to you. Yeah, tell me. So I want you to work with us here as a taxi dancer. Are you sure? But I don't even know the, I'm not even in an intermediate level yet. And she said, I don't mind. I know I can see your personality is good with the people you dance, and the girls are always happy dancing with you. And oh, that's another compliment. Thank you. That's why I think she had some hope on me. And yeah, because I was, for me, I was bad. I think it was an average comparing to others, but for them, I think it was okay. So she asked me to do as a taxi dancer. And then I moved into London, and I was joining, I could say, my father of my teaching journey. It's in Camden, a student in Camden. So I went there. It's also actually another guy from Bolivia, Ramiro Zapata. So he gave me the chance to help him first. And then he left me with two couples to teach or to revise what we did in the middle of the class if they were struggling. So I was trying to teach. But the funny thing was my teaching skill, my English. Yeah? What's the name of this? Palm. Okay, palm, like this. Not like this, like this. That was my teaching at the beginning. So that's it. I started teaching every Wednesday. I was going there, and one couple, three couples, and then they gave me a smaller group, and then a bigger group. So I improved my English. That's a good question, why Dominican Bachata? I even don't know. I don't know. I cannot think on a specific time, date, when or why I started Dominican Bachata. I just remember, because even my teacher, she didn't teach us like this is Dominican Bachata. Of course, at that time, again, there wasn't a difference, Dominican Bachata or Central Bachata. It was Bachata. So, and then she didn't even teach us Dominican Bachata or Dominican steps that we know. Even and we're doing just Bachata, and then just to tell you, I had a new formation course with her in the lockdown, because she specialized more into Dominican Bachata. It was recently. But I remember Dominican Bachata when I was doing congresses. I remember because they were doing like a five rooms at the same time with different styles. And I remember because the warm up they do, they play the music loud, they do warm up all together. And I went the same as you. Oh, you heard the music, it's just, you know, this exciting. And then I went there. I went there to that room where the music was nicer for me. So, and then I started taking these classes, Dominican Bachata. And then I realized it was Dominican Bachata. And then I started doing more like, you know, the pasitos, the fast food work. I started doing it. And it's how I started doing Dominican Bachata. And then I started learning more. I took that course with my teacher, other workshops. So that's the way. But I don't know exactly why or when I went into Dominican Bachata. I don't know. I think they didn't. The bachata at that time. Well, it has been until recently. Even the bachatas, you know, as the original bachata, it's the Dominican. It wasn't known here, not even in Spain. So the bachata was started growing when. They started the Central Bachata. So in Spain, it was doing well. But I think that moment, and then I remember when the Central Bachata started growing is when the Dominican Bachata also started growing. Because some teachers even went back to the roots of Bachata, which is the Dominican Bachata. And then, I don't know, that's here, no one was accepting the Bachata, not even. Dominican Bachata now is getting known, but at that time, no. I like the popularity, but if you get the right direction, because also depends how you see, depends how where you go. probably is damaging the dance, because it's converting, it's the transformation of the dance is probably going at some point in a weird direction, in a wrong direction. Yeah, so as you said, for example, you said sensual, and you also named sexual. So that depends how you see, depends how you apply certain steps, can be too much, can be cross that line. So that's why I can see, and the new generation, for example, who are starting the bachata, if they found that way, is the only way they know, and they think it's normal. But the ones we know, that is not normal. And if you carry on that way, for example, they will see that's normal, so this is nothing. If the lady has been touched here, or the hand of the leader is too close to certain parts of your body, if it's normal, imagine later what it's going to be, if you don't correct that now. So for me, as I've been taught by a good teacher, so that is not acceptable. Yeah, and also the background, I guess my values from my parents, so that's for me is not right. So that is the way that I see that once you cross the line and probably get in a wrong direction. If I have challenges. Yes, I have challenges. When I find, for example, that kind of people who attend to classes and they think they are intermediate advanced, but when we take to the original dance, which is probably easier, but they struggle. So just doing a basic, for example. Doing a basic struggle, so I had people, they're supposed to be an intermediate advanced level sensual bachata. When I'm teaching beginners bachata, fundamentals bachata, Dominican bachata, they struggle to keep the beat, the time. So it's, you know, foundation is always the proper way to learn. But if you're missing that foundation, as we always give the example, a house, you don't have a good foundation, you cannot make a building, a huge building. So, yeah, so that is the challenge right now in the teaching area. They don't know. Many people ask them the same. Intermediate advanced people doing a sensual moderna. Do you know what bachata is? No. Do you know what the instruments are? No. So we are dancing what we are dancing to, you know? But we are intermediate advanced level. An intermediate advanced level should know those things, at least the basic stuff. Because, okay, I have this instrument, and also will give more chance to apply the steps or to play more now the music, to be more musical when you dance. Yeah, so that is a bit struggle for us. I would say respect. Respect in many senses. Respect when you ask, if as a man, as a leader, I will ask to dance to a lady properly. Properly means not like a... Nowadays it's... Yeah, so it's like I will teach like etiquette. To say, okay, I will go to approach you, would like to dance, yes, it'll go. And finish the dance, take you to your place. And after that, when you start dancing, connect with you. Connect. I will see what level you are, or we'll adapt on what level we are. So it doesn't matter if it's a beginner, intermediate. That's something I always teach to the leader specifically. Adapt on your level. So first you need to see in the first steps which level is your partner, and then you can do it. Because a good leader will be always able to dance with a beginner and an intermediate or advanced follower. So that is also part of respect, the movements that you apply, how you position your hands. Sometimes I teach you, I do sensual as well, but for example, when I said to the leader, look, what is the difference? If you put your hand here, that probably is not weird, but let me do it to you. I grab a belly like that, like encrusting digging with my finger. How do you feel? No. But now, what if you touch just like that? Oh yeah, that's nicer. So that's it. That's the way that it's my thing to do to the partner. So that is, for me, that shows respect. Even if I have to touch the belly, but it's not probably comfortable, I will find some other way. But if I have to do it, I will tell the etiquette or two ways to say it. So rather than dig with your fingers like that, just to be softer in the touching. So yeah, so that is respect. Adapt on the level, have fun. So it's not about show off. It's not about I know this much and I will show you. And I'll try to force you to do some steps that you probably don't know. So yeah, so I think respect is there in those senses.
2, 3, 4, and open, close is step, ra,
oh,
is light.
Ra.
Exactly.
Ra.
So remember when we worked the guira, with that, tss, 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 tss. Yeah, so we can play.
Dominican bachata is not always footwork. It's not always fast. It's not always you have to end up the song and be like, you know, sweaty or tired or just I don't want to do another song. Because there are parties where we attend, we are dancing Dominican bachata the whole night. But if you are in the wrong knowledge, so you definitely will be tired after 2-3 songs. But knowing the musicality we were talking before, so you can play with the energies. So how is structured the bachata, how you can play with the instruments. So it's not the same when you have an introduction and start doing the footwork fast and then that's it. You already did like a sprint, but you have to run a marathon. So you will be done in the first 30 seconds, right? So yeah, so that is a I would do. I like to have more people that can do both ways. For example, myself, I had to learn how to follow because it's something that I'm teaching because I'm teaching alone. So that gives me more I don't know what's the word exactly, but versatility to go somewhere, even if I'm alone. So I don't need to have a proper partner to be hired to go and teach somewhere else. So that's why I need to learn as a leader and as a follower. So I like the people, and even more, it's completely new, probably new style where they're promoting like the how they call, I don't remember, but basically it's, so you are dancing as a, you're a follower, I'm a leader, and suddenly we change rules, the roles change. Yeah. So that's it, but without stopping, without telling, now you become the leader, now, so that's it. So there's some signals that straight away you do the leader and now the follower. So both, it's kind of fun to do something like that. And I really like the way that we can now say leaders and followers. So anyone can be leader, anyone can be follower, without thinking about the, you know what, now the new, how can I explain, the new version now, I feel like I'm a male, I feel like I'm a man, and I don't see any disturbing thing on this. So just anyone can lead, anyone can follow and have fun. So we are dancing here for music. So if you like the music, you want to dance, so have fun anyway. So leader or follower, it doesn't matter. Yeah, well, my plans for future are, it's a plan. I have events running. So I have the boat parties. I have some events emphasizing or focused on Dominican bachata, which is very difficult to find in London, apart from the proper local Dominican clubs. And I have the boat parties, and then, so those are my projects, and also organizing, I'm partnering now with the other teachers to organize dance holidays. So yeah, we're bringing people to Spain or to other countries that we can enjoy, specifically the sun and dancing. Ah, also have a big project, which is a cruise for next year. Yeah, we are still working on it, but yeah, this is one of the projects that I'm looking forward to see, like see happening. You know, enjoying again weather, cruise, dancing. So I haven't been in a cruise. I have been in the boat parties, and I could see everyone is 100% happy after leaving or finishing the party. So yeah, those are my projects. And one of my dreams is to have a school, or like a club that I can say, okay, I have my school here for classes and the club as well. It's something that I would like to have. Well, again, it's the same as when we dance with different people. So we are in a different level. We are in a, we can like salsa, bachata. We can not like other styles. Or we can feel our personality goes more with certain styles. So I definitely wouldn't appreciate or hate the rhythm and like the more the other. So I would just say it's not for me, or I didn't have the chance. I would like to try it, but I didn't have the chance. Or it's the same sometimes, you know, some people come to do salsa and they struggle a lot. And they try bachata and they catch very quick, but even quicker than other people who do bachata for longer. Even I remember I was just stepping on my partner's feet all the time. I felt, what a disaster.